Every time I do code review for someone new, I find the same mistakes. Resource leaks is probably the most common and problematic one. If you open a resource and something throws an exception, or you just forgot to close the resource, you'll be in trouble. This happens with files, database connections, sockets, and everything closable. The problem is that everything works, but after a few hours or days when you are in production, you may find your code crashing or stop working due to reaching limits like memory usage, maximum connection or file descriptor open, and similar. And the only way to fix the problem is to go through the whole code base and fix it. A solution is to use the try finally and make sure you close the resource, or you can use the try with resource statement introduced in Java 7. The code will look compact and it's easy to see what is the scope of the open resource. The second most problematic thing is catching and ignoring exceptions. When a function throws an exception, it is because there was a problem. Catching and logging it is not going to do any good, especially if the flow keeps going. You're just hiding the error and going on as if nothing happened. This could also mean that you will have data loss or the operation you're completing will not be correct. And unfortunately, this problem will definitely happen in production. If you don't know what to do with exception, don't catch it. Someone else up in the stack may be able to handle it. You can catch and retro to enrich the exception with some context-specific information. If you're doing HTTP services or similar, not catching an exception should result in 500 internal server error, and it's a better way than returning the wrong result. The other problem that I see a lot is assuming that you may only get a single type of a problem. For example, I see a lot of try catch for insert or update, hoping to receive a duplicate key error. Aside that there may be better methods to do that, the problem here is that you may get other exception than duplicate key. You may get network failures, you may have a problem with your insert parameters or more. So if you want to catch an exception to take an action, at least check if the exception is what you were expecting. Some people are taught to declare all the variables used at the beginning of the function. Unfortunately, sometimes this makes code harder to read and may end up in extra time and memory usage for nothing. If you take a look at this example, map can be declared inside the if block. And in this case, if the if condition is false, we have wasted time allocating a map for nothing. Similarly, the a variable is only used inside the other if block. When we look at the method, we have to look at every line to see where a is used. If we move the a declaration inside the if block, we have reduced the scope of the variable, and the code will be easier to read, since we don't have any other place to check where the variable can be modified. To further improve the readability of your code, you can use the final keyword. Aside from the effect, which is making a variable not reassignable, it should help you out reading and understanding the code. For example, here we know that the key member variable is just assigned in the constructor and not changed by anyone else, just by looking at the declaration. Without the final, we know that count will be changed by some of the method in the class. Similarly, for parameters, we can say that the variable will not be reassigned inside the method. And inside the method, we know that the data variable will not be reassigned. Keep in mind that in case of objects, final does not mean that the object is immutable. From the index variable declaration, we already know that at some point in the code, the variable will be reassigned. The final keyword should help you out when reading someone else's code and should prevent you to reassign things that were not meant to be reassignable. If you're writing utility classes, which are basically just containers for static methods, you should declare a class as final, which means that the class cannot be extended, and add a private constructor to avoid that someone will create an instance. This should improve readability, since just by looking at the keywords, you know that no one will extend the class and no one will create an instance. A lot of code is just transforming the input into something else. Here, there are a couple of improvements that you can do. First, you can avoid the allocation in case if the input is null or empty. Then, you can perallocate the result, since we already know how many elements we are going to transform. Sometimes, these data structures hide too much, and we forget what is going on under the hood. Taking an array list as example, if we don't specify the size in the constructor, we will get an empty array with some prelocated slot. When we insert an item, the backing array is already there. But if you try to insert an item that exceeds the current capacity, a new array is created. In general, the new size is double the current one. The current data is copied over, and the old array gets replaced with the new one. At this point, we have the space for the new item. And this happens again and again. If we know already the final size, or we have an estimate of what will be the final size, we can avoid or reduce the number of reallocation by specifying the size. Most of the data structure backed by an array that Java provides have the size as a constructor parameter. Hash maps are fast, but lookups take time anyway, so don't spend time doing the same lookup over and over. Use a variable, it's cheaper. Similarly, instead of doing a contains and then a get, you can just use get and check if the result is not null. If you have to do something like get the item if present, otherwise insert it, you can use the computeifPresent method. In a single line, you'll do the same. If you're using concurrent-map, this method also saves you the headache of handling concurrent object creation. The atomicity and thread safety provided by concurrent-maps ensure that only one thread can create and insert the object, eliminating the need for additional synchronization. When you have to iterate a map, don't iterate over keys and then do a lookup. Use the entrySet method to iterate both key and value. This will leverage the map internal implementation and it will be faster. If you want to iterate only over the keys, use the keySet method. And if you want to iterate only over the values, use the values method. If you have to iterate over the items to remove some of them, you should be aware of the concurrent modification exception. You cannot iterate and use remove at the same time. A solution is to do a first iteration, accumulate the keys you have to remove, and then iterate over the keys and call remove. Or you can use the iterator. You can get an instance of the iterator, use the asNext and next method to iterate over the items, and then use the remove method of the iterator to remove the current item. This will leverage the internal implementation and it will be faster. Concurrency is hard, and you should rely as much as you can on built-in functionality. Singletons are one example. A lot of times I see code like this, and if timings and the stars are all aligned, this code may work, but it lacks of thread safety and multiple threads can create multiple instances. So this is not the way to do it. The JVM provides at least three ways that take care of the concurrency problem for you. With eager initialization, the instance is created when the class is loaded, regardless of whether it is needed or not. With lazy initialization, the instance is created only when the get instance is called for the first time. And you can also use enums to implement a singleton. Inside the OpenJDK implementation, you can find all the three implementations used. Learning how to avoid resource leaks and avoid silent catches are probably the main mistakes you should be aware of. But there are many more best practices and techniques that will help you improve your code. If you're interested in this topic and want more of this kind of content, click on the like button. If you have any question or want to know more, leave a comment below.